Good morning. Today we are going to reflect on what I learned through creating the solutions to the free response questions in the 2015 AP Physics 1 exam.
Flippin' Physics!
Previously, I did create a video called 8 General Suggestions for the Free Response Questions of Any AP Exam, and with two important exceptions, I am not going to repeat anything from that video. The first one, however, is a repeat. Write legibly. You may think I am kidding, however, I am not. You will not receive credit for any parts the AP graders cannot read. So please write legibly. Graphs are answers, so draw curves and lines carefully. Use a legend to identify different lines. Solid and dotted lines are good options. If a line is straight, use a straight edge to draw that line. Beware of lowercase and uppercase variables. Free response question number 5 had a lowercase m and an uppercase m, which stood for 2 different masses. This confused students. Don't let this be you. Free body diagrams are answers. Draw them carefully. The relative lengths of the arrows represent the relative lengths of the forces. Speaking of forces, only forces appear in free body diagrams. Speaking of forces, label your forces: force normal, force of gravity, force of static friction, force of tension, for example. Do not break forces into components in your initial free body diagram. If you need to break forces into components, redraw the free body diagram. Algebra. Don't let algebraic mistakes be responsible for losing points on the AP Physics exam. So walk through your algebra slowly and carefully, please. There are specific terms you need to be familiar with. Describe means you need to show you understand the underlying physics principles in a situation or event. Explain means you need to provide evidence which clarifies what you just described. Justify means an evidence-based argument to support a previous answer. You will likely include equations and refer to graphs, however, you need to write in full sentences. Derive means to start with fundamental equations. I'll say that again. Derive means to start with fundamental equations and use algebra or geometry to arrive at your final answer. And your final answer will most likely be an equation, however, it might be a number. Calculate means you need to start with an equation, however, it does not have to be a fundamental equation, and then use algebra and/or geometry to arrive at your final answer. And your final answer most likely is a number, however, it might be an equation. What is and determine both mean there is no explanation necessary, they are just looking for an answer. Sketch means to draw a graph which estimates the relationships, and be careful to distinguish between a straight line and a curve. Plot means to add specific data to the graph using a provided scale or a scale you need to create. Weight and mass are not the same. I made an entire video to address this misconception. Click the link if you need a refresher, please. You will have to design an experiment. They will provide you with some possible materials and give you something that they want you to prove or disprove, and you'll have to design an experiment to do so. Guaranteed. There will be short answer and paragraph length response. This means you will have to write complete, legible sentences. You will have to compare different variables. This means you will have to look at a situation and be able to figure out what's going to happen to one variable when you change a different variable. There you go. Please enjoy learning from my AP Physics 1 review videos. Yep, click the link. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you. Hold up. What about that golden nugget of advice that's going to make it so I get a 5 on the exam? Study. Consistently. All year. Great. Thanks.